In order to understand how to install Google Analytics and to interpret what our reports are showing us, it's important to first talk at a very high level about how Google Analytics actually works. Now, in order to retrieve data from users who visit your site, there are two pieces of information that are required. First, users who visit your site must allow Google Analytics to set the first-party cookies that identify the individual users who visit your website. These cookies will gather data on your users as they travel through your site, such as IP address, what type of device they're using, which page they're viewing, and more. Now, if folks have blocked cookies through their browser, then Google Analytics can't track them and it won't work for that particular user. Second, you need to copy the JavaScript tracking code, also known as a global site tag, to your site so that it runs in the user's browser. Once you create an analytics account, you'll be given this unique tracking code that looks something like this. Don't worry about the details of the code for now. Just know this code needs to be implemented on every single page of your site with no exceptions. We'll go over this a little bit more later, but this JavaScript tracking code is essential for data from that web page to transfer back to Google Analytics servers for processing. So speaking of that, how does a segment of data travel from a user's cookie to the report on Google Analytics? Well, let's say that a user is visiting your website for the first time. Now remember, your site must have the JavaScript tag embedded in the HTML of all of your pages in order to track this user. So when your user enters the site in the browser, they access your web server, this is going to return the HTML that your browser will use to show that website to the user. Buried inside of this HTML, the web page will have that embedded JavaScript tracking code which creates and manages the cookies and collects that anonymous information about the user from the browser. As the user continues their journey across your site, that little tracking tag continues to collect data on the actions that it takes, and this sends this information over to Google Analytics servers. It's here in these powerful data centers where Google processes all of this raw data about your user. Now, depending how much traffic volume you have and the type of Google Analytics account, there can be a wide variance in how long it takes from the time a user sees the web page until the data from that session shows up in our reports. The exact details of this can be a little bit complicated, but for our purposes, you can use these guidelines. If you have Google Analytics 360, which is the paid version of Analytics, you are guaranteed your site will be processed in less than 4 hours, although it's actually usually much, much faster. Most of you are going to have a standard free version of Google Analytics. And in that case, if you have less than 200,000 sessions per day, you'll likely see those sessions processed within about 3 or 4 hours. Accounts beyond the 200,000 sessions, sometimes known as visits, per day, will likely skip this intraday processing and only process in that one big batch overnight. In fact, some really large accounts on the free version may see delays up to 48 hours or more until all that data comes in. And it's worth noting that if you have more than 10 million hits per month, Google may force you onto the paid 360 version entirely. Now, once Google's finished processing this information within that 4 to 24 hour time frame, the organized data is going to be delivered to the user-friendly interface available to you within the Google Analytics platform. Here, you'll be able to view the numerous reports on the behavior of users, which we're going to dive into in the rest of this course. Now, it's impressive to see how many insights you're able to glean about your users from such a simple process here. Again, this basic overview is kind of a behind the scenes on how it acquires and reports on the data. If you'd like to see a closer look at this process, do a quick Google search for Google Analytics Developer Guide, which explains the tracking and JavaScript tags in glorious detail.